and welcome here in Produal Academy. My name is Antti Salli and I'm a product manager here in Produal. Today we are taking a little bit deep view on the Produal Proxima Mesh system, how to use FOTA to update transmitters over the air, and example how to use VBU in offline. So let's hop in. In this part we are taking a look how to update the devices, how to update VBU and how to update transmitters by using FOTA, or how to update devices in locally. So let's start how to update VBU. So what we need to do first is to activate the Bluetooth. When we have done the Bluetooth connection to the VBU, we can scroll on the bottom part of the page, and here we can see under the devices part firmware update. And like we can see, there is number one. That means that we have a firmware updates available. By clicking details, we can see that what is the version that we have currently in our VBU, and what is the updated version that we will drive in the VBU. Also, if there is a change log available, we can see from the change log what things is updated on the new version. But here, what we will now do is that we will update this device by clicking update this device. What the VBU is now doing is that it is getting the new firmware version from the MyTool, and MyTool is downloading the update from the cloud to the VBU. This update only updates the VBU, and after this we will take a look how to update transmitters. Now the update is ready, and we can see that we get notification all firmware updates completed successfully. The device is now up to date. So now we can see that everything went good and we can click OK. And now our VBU is up to date. Next, we will take a look how to update the transmitters over the FOTA and locally. After we have made a connection to the VBU, we will scroll on the down part of the page, and under the devices, we will see that there is a firmware update notification. And we have already updated the gateway, so everything is good on the gateway side. But what we can see is that update transmitters has a notification. We will click that, and we will see the information screen where it's told that the FOTA is activated from here, and it can take up to 48 hours. Usually FOTA update is taking from a couple hours to up to this 48 hours. And this is depending on the size of the network. Now, when I have only one transmitter in my network, this should go quite fast on the system. So let's start by clicking update transmitters. And now what is happening is that the MyTool is fetching the update from the cloud to the phone, pushing on the VBU, and then the VBU is updating all the wireless transmitters wirelessly. After the update is pushed to the VBU, we will see the notification. The notification is telling us that the network is now turned to the mesh mode. What will happen next is that the gateway will start to update the transmitters in the network. We can see the progress of the FOTA update under the wireless installation projects. By clicking here, we can see that we have the transmitter FOTA updates and Produal Academy. Produal Academy is our project that we just pushed the FOTA in. I click here and open the page, and here we can see the check status. Under the check status, I can see all the transmitters in the network, what is the current firmware version, and what is the status of the update. This page is generated from the beacon data of the VBU, so we can read this page when we are near of the VBU. After the all transmitters on the network has been updated, we will see the notification here that all the transmitters up to date. There is a two way to update the transmitters, the FOTA or updating transmitters locally. And by doing the local update, we can do it over the Bluetooth. So first we select Bluetooth devices, and we have here VTR that has an older firmware version. What I will next do is to activate the Bluetooth. Now we have made a connection to the VTR, and here on the bottom part, we can see firmware updates. And we have a number one, that means that we have an available firmware update. We click firmware update and update this device. Now the transmitter is getting the latest firmware from the cloud and pushing it to the VTR. Now the transmitter is updated and we can just end commissioning and the transmitter will join back to the wireless network. MyTool is using cloud connection to get firmware updates and saving all the backup data to the MyCloud. But there might be a situation where you don't have no working internet connection. And on those situations, you might need to use MyTool, and we have done so-called offline mode for that. When there is a no internet connection available and you are logging in the MyTool, you can see on the main page, no internet connection working offline mode. By clicking this, we will get the disclaimer that these following features are not working in the MyTool, but we can still use the MyTool as an offline mode. This is something that we don't recommend to use in the daily basis because you don't get the updates and you don't get the backups on the cloud. But example, in the area where is no internet connection, this might be something that you are forced to use. Replacing a broken VBU. There might be a situation where the VBU is broken for reason or another. But no worries, we have a functionality for replacing the broken VBU. So let's start by going on the configurations. Under the configurations, we can find device backup recovery. What this device backup recovery function is doing, it is searching a backup from the cloud based on the serial number of the VBU. So how it is working? I can use the serial number, writing it manually or reading it over the QR code. And in this case, I will now use the QR code. After I have read the QR code, I will search the backups, and the MyTool is now seeing all the backups that is saved to the MyCloud. The broken one is now something that we don't need anymore. We will select latest backup. Then we have the new VBU here. We select choose and load backup to device. And only thing what we need to do is activate the Bluetooth from the new VBU. We can see that we have this VBU. I will take connect. Now we can select operation settings, communication settings, network settings, and override wireless network ID. In this case, we want to override wireless network ID. What this will do, that it will be 100% clone of this previous network. I will click load configuration and install to device. The backup recovery is now ready and we have made a clone from this white VBU to this black one. All the transmitters that were connected to the white one is now connecting to the black one. Now the network is ready to use and we can move on. How to replace VTR from the network? There might be a situation where you want to replace VTR with different model or the VTR is broken one. So in this case, we want to replace this VTR AK with this VTR PK. First, what I need to do is activate the Bluetooth. We can see that the transmitter is appearing here under the new transmitters. Now we have made a connection and we can click network installation. The broken VTR is with ID 1 and we will force this new one to the ID 1 and we will click next, override existing ID. What this will do is that the new transmitter will override the existing one in the ID slot 1. Now we have override the broken VTR with the new one. After you have installed the new transmitter on the network and replaced the old one, make sure that the old transmitter doesn't have battery inside or there is no possibility to activate the removed one. The reason is that if somebody activates the removed transmitter, it will try to join back its old ID. This will cause a conflict where none of the transmitters cannot join the network. How to use wireless pre-scanner? There might be a situation where you need to measure the signal coverage at the site before you have a working network. And we have a solution for that and we are calling as a pre-scanner. We can find it under the wireless installation projects. And here, installation utilities, we have a pre-installation scan. How this is working is that we activate Bluetooth from the VTR. After we have activated Bluetooth, the transmitter will appear here under the new transmitters. You can add as many as transmitters you want, but now I will use this one. Now I have made a connection and I will click signal scanner. Here we can see that now the MyTool is measuring the signal quality from the transmitter to the phone. You can use the transmitters on the site for planning the final installation places for the transmitters. The pre-installation scanner is a nice feature when you need to go on the site and make pre-measurements for the wireless network. You can pre-plan on the site what will be the final installation places for your transmitters by using this pre-scanner. Using MyTool beacon scanner. We can find beacon scanner under the wireless installation projects and here beacon data and scan beacon data. This tool is designed to read data from all Produal products from VBU to VTRs. You can use this even if you don't have an active project or you want to check example temperature of the VTR where is no display or you want to signal what is the status of the VTR. How this works is that the beacon data is activated after the installation for 1 hour and after that it is turned off. But if you need to go later on and check example the battery level or what is the temperature on the VTR, you can activate the beacon data. To activate the beacon data, push the button on the side under 1 second. If you push too long the button on the side, it will activate the Bluetooth and the transmitter will disconnect from the mesh network. When the beacon data is activated, we can read all the data by clicking Show Device Data. Here I can see all the necessary data from this device. The name, serial number, transmitter ID and so on. So this can be used without active project. We can recognize the transmitter by bringing the MyTool very near of the transmitter. Here we can see from the decibels that this is the transmitter 1. Also, the VBU is sending beacon data that we can read from here. So device data is showing us how many transmitters is online on this VBU. If you want to get more detailed information from the VBU, you need to have active wireless installation project on your phone from this VBU. That was all from this time, so I hope that you enjoyed this Produal Academy and get lots of new information about our products. So, see you in coming episodes.